Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and yesterday Apple released watchOS 8.4 RC, or release candidate, to developers and public beta testers. This is the final version that should release to the public unless Apple finds additional bugs in it before the final release. And this particular update was fairly small, about 150 megabytes or so, and I installed it on my Series 7 Apple Watch, but it's available for all watchOS 8 supported devices. Now, along with this, Apple also released iOS 15.3 RC, iPadOS 15.3 RC, tvOS 15.3 RC, and macOS 12.2 RC. So all of those are available now to developers and public beta testers. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go down to general, then about, and the build number just shows us exactly what version we're on. So as you can see here, we're on 19S546. That's the current version as far as the release candidate. If there's a release candidate 2 and they find additional issues, then they'll update this as well. Now, as far as new changes and updates, well, Apple has only mentioned one specific thing, and that has to do with a charging problem that certain devices had. In fact, you can see it right here. It says some chargers may not work as expected. So maybe you were using a third-party charger or an Apple charger. You can plug it in and it will work fine now. So we'll go ahead and plug this in, get our Apple Watch charger here. So now that we have it plugged in, let's go ahead and place it on the charger, and you'll see it starts charging immediately. Now, my daughter actually experienced the charging problem on a MagSafe Duo charger, so this should resolve that issue once 8.4 is released to the public. Now, other than this, they said there's no new notes as far as new features or changes. Some people have reported updates to Home and things like that working a little bit better, but Apple has not mentioned anything specifically. However, they do say that there's security updates, and if we go to the Apple security update website, they haven't updated this yet as it's not available to the public yet. Once this is available to the public, they'll update this website and tell us exactly what's been updated as far as security fixes. So you'll see if we go down, we can find watchOS 8.3, and they'll typically just list what's new as far as security updates and show us everything they've fixed in it. So we'll have to wait until it's released to the public to know 100%, but with iOS 15.3, it looks like that issue where there was a Safari vulnerability that was causing the ability to be tracked across anything you're doing if a website was using indexed DB has been resolved in this update, at least for iOS. So maybe that carries over to watchOS as well, but we don't know specifically what's in it other than that. So it's a very minor update, which is quite odd with a point release. Typically, Apple will push small updates and bug fixes with a point and then another point, meaning 8.3.1 or something along those lines is typically when we have such a small update. Now, when it's released to the public, it's possible they could add more notes to that, but this makes me think that they have something big planned for WWDC and maybe watchOS 9 and iOS 16, where they're not pushing a whole lot of new features. Maybe they're making a major change to all of these devices, and we could see something like that. Now, as far as the release date of this update, well, if we take a look at last year, Apple released watchOS 7.3 on January 26th, along with iOS 14.4. So I would imagine they'll release something along the same lines next Wednesday or so. We could expect the update. It's possible we could see it as soon as Monday, but last year they pushed it around that time frame. So it makes a lot of sense. We'll see it in the early part of the week next week. So that should be available to the public then. And unless there's any major problems found with it, this would be the final version released to the public. And if you're already on it, you'll have the final version early. For those of you wondering about battery life and if this will affect it at all, so far it seems okay, but it will take a few days to know, as we've only had this since yesterday. I took it off the charger this morning a couple hours ago, and I'm down to 95% battery life. So that's pretty good. Although I haven't done a whole lot with it, I haven't done any workouts or gone for a walk or anything. I've typically just used it for notifications right now, but it seems to be okay that way. And if we take a look at my battery health, we'll go down to battery here. We'll find it. There we go. Battery. And go down to battery health. This device is at 100%. That's because it's a Series 7 and fairly new, but this will go down over time. Typically 80% after 2 years is normal. And my last watch, the Series 6, after using it an entire year, was down in the lower 90s. So 92, 93%, which is what you would really expect. As far as overall performance, it doesn't seem to be really any different than it was before. Apps that I don't use all of the time seem to be opening nice and quick. Or if we go into maybe something else, we'll go into music, you'll see it's nice and fast there. Or let's even go into, well, heart rate. I haven't opened that in a while. You'll see it comes right up. So it's nice and fast. I've not really had any issues with it. And I wouldn't expect this particular update to affect anything as far as performance, since it's a minor bug fix and basically a security update. Not a whole lot going on in this update, which is surprising, like I said. And so that's everything in watchOS 8.4 release candidate. Not a whole lot going on. Again, Apple could update those notes before it's released to the public or when they release it to the public. And then, since many of you ask, this particular watch face, a lot of people want to know what it is. It's Infograph Modular, as you can see here. It's Infograph Modular. And then in the center, I have the app called Lumi. So you'll see there's Lumi. It's a paid app, but I paid for it and then installed it. And the app called Lumi is in the middle. You have a couple different options with that. And so that's something a lot of you have asked about, and I try to answer in every single watchOS video, since I like this watch face so much. So that's it for this particular update. If you found anything more, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.